Welcome back on this Friday. Well, we have heard from Florida Governor Ron DeSantis that woke goes to die in Florida, and now his latest move seems to align with that. The Republican governor's administration is blocking an advanced placement African-American history course from the state's high school curriculum. In a letter obtained by ABC News, the Florida Department of Education rejected the course, calling it inexplicably contrary to the Florida law and significantly lacks educational value. Joining me for more, ABC News Deputy Political Director Avery Harper. Wow, Avery. So I guess let's start with, how did the Department of Education make this determination?
Right. Well, we don't know. It's not entirely clear. I've asked the Florida Department of Education for more information about how it came to this decision. What we do know is that Florida Governor Ron DeSantis has made issues surrounding education central to his reelection effort and to his new term. If you listen to his speech from his inauguration earlier this month, he did say that Florida is where woke goes to die. And he said that he is trying to root out trendy ideologies from the state school. That has largely translated to not only restrictions on conversations and curriculum about race, but also about gender identity and sexual orientation.
Right. So, and we've talked about how DeSantis is behind the Stop Woke Act, which, as you touched on there, you know, avoids these race-related content in workplaces and schools and colleges. But what exactly was set to be taught in this specific course?
Right, so this course is an advanced placement course that allows for high school students who elect to take this course to get college credit if they pass an exam at the end of it. And what the College Board has described this course as being is a exploration of the contributions and the experiences of African Americans across this country in areas such as political science, history, arts and humanities, in geography, and lots of different things.
So Florida State Senator Shervin Jones tweeted this out, saying that schools have AP classes for European history, Japanese language and culture, German, Italian, and Spanish. Have we heard from the DeSantis administration about what makes African-American studies any different?
Right. The Florida Department of Education has really been tight-lipped about this. But what I think this really lends itself to is the conversations that other Republican-led states are having about curriculum and conversations in the classroom about race and about race relations. And so what we've seen in Florida is this pervasive effort to root that out, not only in schools, but also in the workplace as well. So we're still waiting for more answers from the Florida Department of Education about what this exactly means.
Well, and also, too, advanced placement courses, AP courses, count for college credit. So is there any chance that Florida's rejection could actually derail the course's rollout across the country?
Right. I reached out to the College Board. I was speaking with representatives from the College Board earlier today, and they essentially said that they're going to continue to pilot this course. This is a course that is being piloted in 60 high schools across the country. It says, in part, like all new AP courses, AP African American Studies is undergoing a rigorous multi-year pilot phase, collecting feedback from teachers, students, scholars, and policymakers. The process of piloting and revising course frameworks is a standard part of any new AP course, and frameworks are often significantly changed as a result. So we're waiting to see what happens there.
Yeah, so are we. We'll stay on the story. Avery Harper, thank you so much.